plug.
What's up, everybody? This is Retro Reviews Plus here, and we are doing a review and play of Metal Slug, the first one.
Thank you.
I'm giving myself some credits right now. Let's do 20 credits to see if I can beat the game on that. Okay, yeah, I'm doing a video here. Here's the instructions of how to play it. A is to fire, B is to jump, C is your grenade. It's pretty straightforward. So yeah, I haven't done a video in a while. Sorry, I've been gone for a long time. Just been, you know how life is. It's when you got kids and responsibilities, you know, life kind of gets in the way of your YouTube videos, but that's to be expected. So anyways, without further ado, let's get started with some Metal Slug. And this is a straightforward run-and-gun game, pretty much like Contra. I basically call it Contra on steroids. I mean, I love Contra, but, I mean, this game just kind of, like, you know, amps it up a little bit. You gotta save these prisoner guys, and they'll give you a little, I got killed already. They'll give you goodies. Graphics are really, really great. I mean, those are really, you know, hand-drawn sprites. They're pretty impressive in my opinion. To me, this game, the graphics are great to look at. I mean, look at the detail there, the background, the waterfall and everything. I mean, that's pretty awesome. Yeah, this is definitely one of my favorite games for the Neo Geo. Here's the first boss. First boss done. The only bad thing about the game is, like, if you do die, like any prisoners you rescue, you don't get credit for. So you basically have to, if you want to get all credit for every prisoner, you basically can't die.
Mission 2, start. Thank you.
I love the rocket launcher. It's my favorite weapon. This here's like a mini boss, I guess. Like a mid-level mini boss. Level 2. These bosses can be challenging. They take a lot of hits. Gotta get out of your tank when it turns red like that. I'm out of grenades. See there, I died at the end, so I got no credit for prisoners.
Mission complete.
But yeah, when you think of the Neo Geo, this is like pretty much one of the first games that you think about that comes to mind. It's just a fun game. I mean, not just the action of the game, but it is comical. You know, the reactions of the enemies, some of the, you know, the like expressions on their faces and everything. Dang it. Yep, continue. Didn't jump far enough. You gotta jump like that. Yep, some of them jumps are close calls. I think that guy went down on a toilet. Is that a toilet there? I just noticed that. Yeah, I think that's a toilet. So this game has some good effects. And then when you get in your tank, or that's actually what the metal slug is your tank. Have unlimited fire on your like machine gun or laser gun, and you do have limited fire on your as far as your cannon. I just got this on the factory setting at as far as difficulty. I think it's like number 4, so you can change the difficulty on this game. I think it can, I think it ranges from like, you know, 0 to 10, so it's like on 4 right now, so it's about average.
Mission 4, start.
Yeah, I don't think I can get up here and get it.
Machine gun.
No, like, yeah, that came in there and knifed me.
Machine gun.
It is easy to die in this game. That is the one thing. I mean, it is challenging. Like. It is, you know, like Contra, one hit, and yeah, you're dead.
Okay. Thank you. Heavy machine gun. Okay. Rocket launcher.
Dang it. And I'm just trying to do a speed run here. I'm not point pressing or anything, you know, because you can't get those. Those tanks up on the hill there. You can act on this one here. You can actually like shoot the ground. Oh, that guy! Wow, what a cheap shot. See, yeah, the ground gives way and the tank falls down.
Rocket launcher.
Shotgun is good for up close battles. It is very powerful. Ah.
Heavy machine
And they actually made quite a few of these games. I mean, Metal Slugs. There's like, I think it went up to part maybe 7 or 8. I only have 1 and 2 right now. I would like to get part 3. For a lot of people, part 3 is, they consider that to be the best one.
Later stages, they are tough.
lot of stuff going on here, coming from both ends, both sides. I think that helicopter is taking more hits than it should. Bosses, they do take a lot of hits. Like I said, there's really not much to say about this game. It's a straightforward run and gun game. But it is fun, you know? I mean, it's one of those games where if you don't want to think about too much, you just want to go shoot some stuff and blow some stuff up. Oh, there's a prisoner guy there hiding up there. That was cool. Took care of all those guys at once. Yeah, you're basically in a war here. Yeah, like I said, I'm not the best at this game. I mean, I know there's... I'm sure there's a lot of guys out there who can probably get to this game and never get killed. I'm just not that, you know. Just not that good, not that skilled. But wow. Final boss that just shot that in that helicopter. This is pretty cool. You're on a boat here. Let's get this big Gatling gun here. Yep, here's the final box. And you will die many times here, because, like I said, all the bosses take a lot of hits. But this guy here especially. Best thing to do is unload your grenades as soon as you can. All 10 of my grenades. We start off with 10 grenades. That's Metal Slug, boys and girls. Continued 14 times. Let's put my initials in here. So that means I went through, and they get three guys with each continue. So if you do the math here, 30, 45, so about 42 guys I went through. These are just the ending credits here. Like I said, it's kind of comical. There's a bit of humor to the game. So it's not like a dark, even though you do kill, you know, a lot of killing and blowing up things, there's still like a humor to it. It's not a dark game at all. I consider a fun, you know, fun game. Yeah, the graphics are great, you know, really nice, really enjoyable to look at. Nice rainbow in the background. Good animation too, the birds and just everything. Especially that the waterfall effect, I really dig that. So basically, the follows a little paper airplane back all through the, showing you all through the game where you went. Forever. So as you can see, I am number one there in the points, and you will be if you go throughout to finish the game like that. But yeah, if you're really looking for points, there's I could have got a lot more points if I wanted to take my time and do all that, because there's a lot of hidden things you can shoot, like buildings. You can shoot, you can shoot those buildings all up and get points for every shot you hit. So, anyways, guys, I hope you enjoyed this. Switch it to the next game where there's snow. Yep, those are the four games I got in there. Well, anyways, guys, hope you enjoyed this video of Metal Slug. If you haven't played this game for the Neo Geo, I definitely recommend it. You'll have a good time. If you guys got any questions or comments, list them below. I'll get back to you as soon as I can. So, until next time, guys, have a good one.
Oh, thank you.
Oh.